The Model 3030 series of sample counters are dual-channel counters designed for simultaneous alpha and beta sample measurements. In this video, we will use the term 3030 to represent all of the 3030 variants. Some versions have slightly different features and configurations, but the operating procedures are essentially the same. This video is for basic use of the instrument as shipped from the factory. All parameters are set for factory default settings. Advanced features will be demonstrated in a later video. The front panel controls and displays are an alpha channel display that is a 6-digit backlit LCD readout, which indicates counts received in the alpha counting channel. A beta channel display that is a 6-digit backlit LCD readout, which indicates counts received in the beta counting channel. A QC check button that starts the quality control check cycle and resets the two counters when depressed. Pressing this button during a QC check will restart the process. A count button that resets and starts the counting cycle, and it resets the two counters when depressed. A count time rotary switch that allows the selection of preset count times, or a PC position that selects the user-defined count time. A volume knob that varies the audio output. A sample drawer that is used to hold the sample during a count cycle. Inside the sample drawer is a reversible tray insert. The insert can hold samples up to either 2.5 centimeters or 5 centimeters in diameter and is 1 centimeter thick. The tray insert is held in place by a set screw on the left side. A tray switch, which is a rotary control used to latch the sample tray. It also lifts the sample tray into position and blocks all extraneous light from the detector. The tray switch should always be in the latched position while counting. An on-off rocker switch that applies power to the instrument when in the on position. The front panel has status LEDs to indicate the condition of the instrument. These consist of a QC light, which is a red LED indicator that illuminates whenever a QC check is needed. After a QC check is performed and passed, the QC indicator turns off. An OL light that is a red LED indicator that illuminates whenever the internal circuitry detects a current overload to the detector. This warning typically indicates an open sample tray or a torn window on the front of the internal detector. The instrument will not count while this indicator is illuminated. A CPM light, which is a green LED indicator that illuminates when the CPM mode is enabled. A DPM light, which is a green LED indicator that illuminates when the DPM mode is enabled. An alpha alarm light, which is a red LED indicator that illuminates whenever the alpha count exceeds the alarm level. A beta alarm light, which is a red LED indicator that illuminates whenever the beta count exceeds the alarm level. Basic use. Turn the power switch on. The readout LEDs will illuminate and the instrument will display all 8s and colons as a test of the segments. Then it will display the 5-digit firmware number. Next, it will display the version number. The instrument is now ready for use. Adjust the volume of the speaker to the desired level with the volume knob. The alpha and beta clicks have a different tone to help distinguish them from each other. Adjust the count time switch to your desired count time. The factory default operating mode is scalar count. In this mode, the QC button is disabled. Rotate the tray latch knob to unlatch and slide the tray open. You will see a 2-inch diameter sample holder. Note that the sample holder comes secured to the left side of the tray by an Allen screw from the factory, so it will stay in place during shipping. A 1-inch diameter holder is available if you loosen the Allen screw and turn the sample holder over. We recommend that the Allen screw be kept tightened during use to prevent the sample holder from coming into contact with the detector and causing damage. Close the tray, turn the tray knob to the latched position. Press the count button and the instrument will begin a count. Colons will be displayed during the count. At the end of the count, the colons will disappear and the total number of counts received in the alpha and beta channels will be displayed. That's all there is to using the 3030 in its most basic form. Thank you for watching.